Hello there, it's Graciela here. In today's video, we're going to be learning how to create dynamic approvals in Power Automate. So for this use case, what we want to do is that we want to send the approval request to different people depending on the department that the SharePoint record belongs to. So in this case, we have this project list in which we have we can assign different projects to different departments, and different users will approve depending on the department that the project belongs to. So in this case, we already have a SharePoint list where we have the list of departments, and we already created a lookup column against our projects table that connects a department with the project. So now what we need to do is just to be able to send it to different people. So for that, let's go to the SharePoint list that has the department list. So we are here, and what we need to do is to just add a new column, and we are going to add a new person column. So let's hit on next, and we are going to call these approvers. So we go to more options and we allow multiple selections. In this case, it's because there can be more than one approver. But if you know that only one approver is going to be added, then you can just leave it as no, and that should be okay. But in this case, we want to be able to send it to one or to more than one. So let's hit on save, and then I'm going to edit in grid view. And for the first list, I'm going to send it for this Power GI user, and I'm also going to send it to myself. And for finance, it's going to be only for myself. So in this case, you can keep adding more approvers. There could be two or three or four, or as many as you would prefer. For example, if there are five of them, you can add the five users with no issues. But in this case, since we are testing and we only have access to two users, then in that case, we are only going to use two users. So let's exit the grid. And now the setup that we need to create these dynamic approvals is complete. And now we can go to Power Automate to create our workflow. So once in the portal, you can either go to solutions and add the flow to the solution that this development is related to. Or in my case, since this is just a demo, we are going to create it from the portal directly, and we are going to go to new flow and then automated cloud flow. And we want this to be triggered every time a new item is created, because every time a new project is created, we want to send it to approval. So we are going to call this dynamic approvals. And let's hit on create. So first things first, let's select what's the SharePoint site that we are working with, which is this one, and then the list name is projects. And then we need to grab what's the list of approvers. So in this case, we are going to get that by adding a new action that will query against the department's list to find who are the approvers. In this case, since we are adding all the approvers in a single line, we just need to know what's the ID of the marketing record, for example, to be able to bring it. So in this case, since we will only have one row for each department, but one department can have many approvers, we can use the action that is called getItem. So let's look for the SharePoint action, which is getItem. And then we are going to select the SharePoint group again. And we are going to do this against the department's table. And we are going to pass the department ID as the dynamic content. And you can see it's here. So we're just going to pass it and then click on add. We are going to save and test quickly just to make sure that we are able to get the list of approvers. But first, let's just rename this to get approver list, and then let's save and test. And let's add a new item in the meantime. And save. Let's just wait for the flow to run. Okay, so it just ran. Seems like the new editor, well, it's here now. So we are just going to get the approvers list, and you can see that we have here the two approvers that are related to marketing. So these are the two users that we need to send this approval to. So for that, let's go here to edit, and we are going to add a create and wait approval. So we're going to start and wait for an approval. And here is, for example, where we decide if everyone must approve, if just the first to respond. So in this case, we're going to do everyone must approve. After we select that, it's going to ask us some information. And then we're going to pass a title. And for now, we're just going to pass the project name for the sake of testing. So we're going to pass the title from the trigger, and we are going to also add the item link, also comes from the trigger. And here is where the dynamic part comes from. So in this case, you would usually select, for example, the user that will have to approve. But in this case, we want to assign it to more than one user, which now we have said a couple of times that it should be dynamic. So what we can do, for example, is just send the list of users separated by a semicolon. But in this case, we need this to be dynamic based on what comes from the approver list. So what we are going to do is we are going to use a select action to get the approver lists from our SharePoint list and then just pass those emails to this action. Because for now, if we leave it like this, it's always going to be sent to these users. But what we can do is we can click on the plus icon and then look for the select action. And it's here under data operation. We're going to add it here, and it's going to ask us what do we want to do. So what we want to do is we want to extract only the email field from the approvers list, because you can see that a lot of information comes from the get approvers list, and we only need the actual email, which is what we have here and what we have here. So for that, we are going on the select action in the from section. We are going to select the approvers list, and you can see that Power Automate recognizes that the approvers schema or the approvers data type is compatible with the from, because here what we do with the select action is to select a list of columns from a list of values that we want to display. So in this case, we are going to display only the email and ignore pretty much everything else. So let's click on approvers, and then here we are just going to select the approver email. And if I write here, for example, email, and then we test it as it is right now. And here what we want to do is we want to see how the select action looks. So you can see how the select action received a lot of data from the previous action. But here in the outputs, it only gives us back the emails, and that's really what we're looking for. So we don't really care about the name or anything else about the approvers result. We only need the email. So these two emails is what we are going to use. So let's go back to edit. And here I'm going to click on this switch to text mode action. And I'm going to remove everything else that we have here. And we are only going to leave email. Because you saw in the previous result that what we had, well, the modern editor can be a little bit weird when it comes to the select action and when we want to trick it to not bring the column name. So I'm going to switch to the classic designer. So we're going to switch without saving. So what we want to do is we want to extract this only as text and not as an array. And not as an object. So you can see here that now we have this property called email. The end result of what we want to achieve is just this. We want an array of just the email only, like this. So to trick that, to trick Power Automate to do that for us instead of bringing this column name, what we need to do is, first go to the classic designer, because the new designer is a little bit weird on this change, because it doesn't like the JSON format. So we switch here to text mode using that icon, and then we remove everything. Once you remove everything, Power Automate will convert this kind of JSON object into just a flat array that will have only the emails. So now, for example, we can just resubmit this. Well, we can cancel and then resubmit. And we're going to see how Power Automate now, instead of giving us these columns, it's just going to give us a flat array, as you can see here, with just the emails. And now it's going to be quite simpler to just convert these emails into just the text that Power Automate is expecting for this action. So in this case, what we can do is we can use the join function. So we can add here a compose action. And we are going to use the join expression to take the array, the result that we have previously, which is just a flat array, doesn't have any column name. And then we are going to join those two texts or three texts, depending on the number of emails that we have. If there are five of them, we're going to merge them together by using a splitter. In this case, it's going to be a semicolon because that's the format that Power Automate expects. So what this join function will do is that this will convert this format into this other format. It's going to take those two values and just join them by using a semicolon. And you can see that this is exactly the format that Power Automate is waiting here for the approval. So once we have the list of approvers in the right format, we can just remove the assigned to, and we can just assign it to the result of the compose action. And now we can just click on save, and we can just have it sent again. We are going to test it. We are going to add one for finance and one for marketing, so we can see both of them. Marketing test, and we're going to put it as marketing. And we're also going to do one for finance test. And we're going to select finance. So in the marketing example, two people should receive the approval. In finance, one person should receive it. So let's go back to the run history and let's wait for the executions to happen. Okay, so here's one. Let's click on edit columns so we can see the title and we can see which is which. So we have finance test and marketing test. If we open marketing and then if we open finance. Let's switch to the classic designer so we can see there how the emails look. And you can see here that the list of approvers for the marketing item was retrieved correctly, and we can see how the list of approvers was changed to this format, and this is what we are sending to the approval action. And then in the finance approval, we see that there's only one email correctly recognized as we had it here. And if we go, for example, and my user has one approval for finance, and one approval as well for marketing, because this user is listed in both of them. And you can see how the one for marketing is also pending on this Power GI user. So it was correctly routed to the users. And if we go to these other users, you can see that this user only received the marketing test and they didn't receive the finance. And this is an example on how we can create dynamic approvals on Power Automate based on a SharePoint list. I hope that this was useful for you. See you next time.